Thank you, Mr. Moderator. As always, it is an honor to be before you with these wonderful men and women that are coming up onto the stage, serving diligently and tirelessly as in many chaplaincy roles throughout our country and military bases around the world. Let us pray. God, may the word I'm about to speak be so, so pleasing to you. In Christ's name I pray, amen. Scrolling on the screens, in just a second, you will see all of our military chaplains, our 80 plus now EPC chaplains, and the type of chaplaincy in which they minister. On stage with me today are those chaplains and chaplain work and care committee members that were able to manage or were permitted by their institution to make it to GA this year, with most of them actually enjoying an uplifting and educational chaplain's retreat prior to GA at Glen Eyrie Castle in near Colorado Springs. It was a joy that we were able to cover all expenses related to that retreat, even airfare, through the Care of Chaplains Fund. That chaplains, yeah, it was awesome. So that chaplains and some presbyteries and some of you had given to even, and I'm just so thankful for you and I appreciate that so much. Had I not had that gift to give, many couldn't have afforded to go to that retreat on relationships or seek support to come even to GA. You may not be aware that chaplaincy is the fastest growing form of ministry in the United States today. These before you offer ministry beyond the walls, being at the forefront of ministry and going to where people are, their very work centers, their very daily lives, that no one else in ministry can go. They bring an intentionality of presence as an invited guest and find themselves used by God to help those entrusted to them through some of the most difficult and challenging times in their lives, being directly available in the midst of their workplace. As highly skilled, trained, and godly professionals, chaplains complement the work of the church to provide a reach to people that might not darken the door of a church, but yet yearn for some sort of spiritually anchored support, or maybe just a listening ear and a shoulder to lean on in their challenges of life. Chaplains can also be a signpost to cause people to seek out the fellowship and importance of being involved in a church fellowship if they choose to do so. It really takes a combination of special qualities to be a chaplain. The Chaplains Work and Care Committee, or CWCC, consists of 9 members, both teaching and ruling elders, some who are on stage with us today, along with me as the chaplain endorser. The CWCC and endorser are supported by Michael Davis, our assistant stated clerk, and also the endorser and CWCC has enlisted the gracious support of a volunteer administrative assistant, Dave Snyder, a retired Army chaplain who's back there somewhere. It's great to see so many up here on stage. The military and many civilian institutions require their chaplains to have undergone specific training, have a master's degree in a relevant field, be ordained, and be ecclesiastically endorsed by their denomination's endorsing agency. Endorsement helps to ensure that all individuals seeking to serve as chaplains are well vetted and suited for this specialized type of professional ministry, and that we are meeting the expectations of institutions that are asking us to send us the most qualified, the best of our best, to serve. The CWCC and I handle that process together. The committee's secondary, but just as important function, is to be partners with chaplains and be an encourager to guide and support them to help ensure their connection with their ordaining presbytery or geographically located presbytery for military chaplains. As endorser, my secondary but just as important function is to provide continuing support and accountability with chaplains through personal visits to them at their workplace, as well as with their leadership. I also ensure they receive annual continuing education and training to better equip them in their work. There's much more I could say about this, but it covers the highlights. In addition, we develop and implement policies and procedures and protections for EPC chaplain ministry and provide pastoral care for chaplains and their families as opportunities allow. In an effort to help presbyteries better understand the endorsement process and how we can support them in their process, provide insight into what makes a great chaplain, and gain a clearer picture of the myriad forms of chaplaincy amongst various secular institutions, I plan to visit and speak at all 16 presbyteries before the next General Assembly, beginning with 6 this fall. And I'm looking forward to being with many of you this coming year. Excited about that. As author Wendy Cage so eloquently wrote in her article, The Rise of the Chaplains, many Americans are turning to chaplains to meet their emotional, spiritual, and mental needs. She noted that growing numbers of Americans, especially under the age of 30, are not religiously affiliated or involved with any kind of spiritual or religious organization. And I'm so excited to hear that the EPC is going to be making a very distinct effort to change that and reach out more into the community to folks that are needing to hear the gospel of Jesus Christ. But she went on to say, with that going on, they're not seeking local religious leaders like our grandparents or parents used to do. And many turn to chaplains and spiritual care providers who are in the midst of their workplace. Gallup, in 2022, reported that the rise in chaplaincy that most Americans who have been served by a chaplain have found that interaction to be positive and valuable, even from those who consider themselves not even religious. Theological schools have recognized this rapid growth, with more than a quarter of them now having MDiv programs focused on chaplaincy. The slide behind me shows a small piece of where our chaplains serve. Our chaplains are everywhere. Hospitals, including palliative care to children and for families facing the looming death of their child. Serving at Arlington National Cemetery, where our chaplain has performed 1,000 plus funerals in his 2+ years there. Hospice chaplains support patients in their last days and for their family members. Athletes facing tough decisions and challenges in life. Prison ministry, schools, universities, presbyteries even, supporting the youngest military members to generals. Serving first responders as fire, police, EMT, and disaster response chaplains in the midst of tragedy and families affected. And in recent years, more and more Fortune 500 companies such as Tyson Foods have started to engage chaplains. There has been a rapid growth in marketplace chaplains. There's an estimated 2,000 plus chaplains serving over 1 million employees and family members within nearly 1,500 companies from California to New York. Employee reaches out to a chaplain every 4 minutes. That's pretty cool. Marketplace chaplaincy is growing. It's voted as the number one benefit by most employees, and that's pretty awesome. And chaplains work in a number of different organizations that reach out. Red Cross, we have a chaplain that went to Turkey and was there for earthquake relief, serving the Billy Graham disaster response team and working with them as a chaplain. Chaplains are pastors in many ways. Chaplains are interpreters. They try to identify, understand, and share in issues affecting the culture of a particular context. They're ambassadors. They represent the church. They're prayers. They pray for people constantly. And they're connectors. They connect people, and they connect them with their faith or with faith that could be part of them. With 80-plus endorsed EPC chaplains and many more serving in even volunteer chaplain role, you got chaplains in your presbytery. I want to encourage you to pray for your chaplains. Pray as you get to know them. Pray as you see them here. I have so much joy in serving our chaplains. I could not be prouder of them as they continue to provide excellence in ministry in the midst of secular environments that are not always friendly to having them there. A scripture verse I've always rested on, he comforts us from 2 Corinthians 1:4, in all our troubles so that we can comfort others. When they are troubled, we will be able to give them the same comfort God has given us. Amen to that? Before my brother Michael prays over our chaplains, if you are interested at all in serving as a chaplain in any capacity, and there's so many, and there's many more that could be on there, please seek me out here at GA or contact me at my email, that's showing on the screen. I would love to talk to you. Michael.
Thank you, Mark. I would ask all of the chaplains, will you guys scoot down this way? There's a green line. We want to put you in view right before we pray. And we just make those two lines. That'd be great. Thank you, sir, within that green line. Excellent. Thank you, Mark. And as we pray, everyone, I want you to pray with me as we pray for our chaplains, because this is a very important ministry in our church, I mean, within our denomination. And thank you, Mark, for all of what you do for us. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we love you. We thank you because you have given us so many great gifts. And those gifts come now as chaplains. They're gifts to the particular areas in which they serve, because they intercept, they intervene, they care, they shepherd, they preach, they teach, they cry and weep with others. They also rejoice with others that are glad. They do so many different things in the areas in which they serve that sometimes it is hard and weary, and they may feel alone and isolated. No matter where they are, Lord, you remind them that you're with them always. And I pray, God, that you continue to be with them as they are in their places and they are sent out to serve and love as you have called them to. And I pray, Jesus, that you give them the fortitude, the resilience. And God, you also give them the support and the community around them that is needed. Bless their families, those that have families, extended families, everyone around them, to continue to support them. The things that they are doing that they can't articulate or explain, or things that are difficult and hard, I pray, God, that you give them spaces and places where they can speak about those things, have therapy and counseling to help them to be more effective as they continue to work for your kingdom and for your glory. For we pray this in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. All God's people say together,
amen.
Thank you.